If you guys want the best free Windows executor for Roblox, I'll be showing you number one, how to install it, number two, how to use and set it up, and third, showing you the features and how to execute scripts. So to get started, you guys are going to want to head to the first link in the description where you guys will see this page. And once you scroll down on this page, you'll see this blue download button. Of course, you want to download it right, but you're going to want to click and X out two times because there's two pop-ups, guys. But on the third time you click, it'll actually let you continue to the download. Click on verify. You're a human, and then as you guys can see, it says Nazir executor.zip and it is locked. Wait, is that normal? Actually, guys, this is normal. This is something normal for every Roblox executor, and this is called a false positive, which happens when a antivirus software falsely detects flags on a software. And this is the case because Roblox executors mess with the in-game code of Roblox to execute scripts internally. So in order to continue, you guys are gonna want to do Control and J on your keyboard, which will open this menu right here, which is your downloads. But before you guys continue, you're gonna actually wanna minimize that window. Then you're gonna wanna go over to your desktop and you're gonna wanna search for Defender. And then you're gonna find something like Windows Security. So open that up. And then you guys are gonna wanna navigate to your virus and threat protections. And then under virus and threat protection settings right there, you're gonna wanna click on manage and then real time protection off. And then it'll look a little like this with it off. And this is required, guys, because your antivirus will also have false positives, which will delete files that the executor needs to actually function. But if you guys are not using Windows Defender and you're still having issues, that means likely that you're using a different antivirus. So in this case, you're gonna need to go to YouTube and search up how to disable, put your antivirus's name and enter, and then you guys should see a bunch of thorough videos on how to disable the antivirus that you have. But once you've done that, go back, open up your window once again, guys, and then go to the three dots on the download and click on download dangerous file. Then it'll open up another window. Then you're gonna wanna click on continue anyway, and then click on I trust this site and download. And then it should successfully download. So now you guys can click on this little folder icon, which will show you where it's downloaded. So I'm gonna go ahead, move the zip to my desktop, and then I'm gonna do extract files. And once you've done that, you should get a folder like this. Now you guys can just delete the zip. You don't need it anymore. And if we open this up, now we are ready to open the executor. So just double click on Nazir underscore interface, and then that will open up this key system. But first, it will also open up the key system where you guys will get your free key, along with the website where you guys can purchase a keyless version of the executor. So this will make it so you guys don't have to do the key system and use a completely keyless. So it's pretty good. But let's go to the first checkpoint of the key system, guys. So you're gonna want to click on download best gaming browser. This is just a typical Loot Labs, you guys know the drill, right? You click, you wait. So let me get the green check mark in just a minute or two. Boom, there we go, we got that green check mark. So now we can continue on to the next step. So once again, you guys are given a prompt to get a lifetime key if you want, or you can get to the next checkpoint of the free key system. And if you guys do want to get a key, I'll be leaving a link in the description. But let me show you how to do the work inks easily without, you know, having a bunch of issues. So first off, you're gonna just want to spam skip, just keep skipping on these offers pages right here, and then just click on go to destination, and that should allow you to just continue. Click on next checkpoint once again. Same deal, guys. So go to destination, choose a different offer, and just skip. Just skip. I don't want any of it. And then click on go to destination, at which point you can continue on to the last checkpoint right here.
Finally!
Go to destination, choose different offer, and then skip. No, none of it. I don't want any of it. Go to destination. And that should get you guys the license key. Boom, there we go. And now you guys should save this license key, because once you close this window, it's gone. So save it real quick. Let's make a new TXT right here. My key. And let's just paste it into there. Save it just so we have it for later. But let's input our key right there. And then we click on verify key. And boom, there we go. Welcome back. Click the button to continue. And now let's load into a game real quick. And if you remember, guys, you previously had to do a bunch of weird stuff and, like, you know, use different versions of Roblox, but that is no longer the case. You can use any version of Roblox. You just launch it up and you're good to go. You just execute. And once you've loaded up, you're going to want to go to your client section. Make sure your client is selected that you guys are using. Now that we've selected our client, let's go over to our script hub. Let's just select Infinite Yield, for example, real quick. And boom, there we go. We got that up. So let's do the classic, guys. Let's do the classic. Let's load into this map because this is going to go crazy. And in a second, guys, I'll show you some other scripts. Hey, yo, what? Why'd I fall? Okay, anyway, let's lock in right here. Let's fly first off, and then we're gonna want to do flank. All right, and this is the best thing to do on this map because you guys can literally fling people to oblivion. As you can see, I flung myself. Let me get back first, okay? Let me do that again because you guys can disintegrate these pods on this carousel. Or is that what it's called? I'm not even that sure. But anyway, there's a person in this one. Let's fling him. We both just got disintegrated. There we go. And if you guys watched that trolling video I did, you know some another cool features, which is the TP all on ankle. Let's do this purple guy right there. All right. And if we go over to our parts over here that are unanchored and we do that, all the parts get teleported to that guy. So let's keep doing that. Let's get all the blocks over to that dude over there. Yep. Let's just bring them all to the spawn. Oh my gosh. That is. Oh, there goes a whole carousel. Oh, and he just died, I think. Yeah, it works pretty well, as you can see. We got the carousel on the spawn. Oh my gosh, guys, this is insane. We're flinging all the different parts, and the map is basically clean now. There's nothing left, literally. But I don't want to bore you guys. Let's go into blocks, fruits. Then let's go ahead and do, like, dark decks first. Or no, just decks. Dex Explore. It's not dark mode, okay? So as you guys can see... Hey, yo, leave me alone, bro. Okay, okay. Back on track. So as you guys can... Dang. What I do to him? Okay, anyway, we got our Dex Explorer, as you guys can see right here. So we can see all the different elements of blocks fruits and we can inspect them and try to make like a script, for example, for ourselves to auto farm or, you know, that type of jazz. So it's pretty useful tool. If you guys are looking into doing that, you can see a bunch of all the different maps and all that good stuff. And if you guys haven't noticed, they've also updated their UI and I think they're still working on improving it. This is like a beta version of their new UI. So, you know, you got way more script tabs now, finally. That's something good. And you also guys have a script searching section because, of course, you can come over here and save scripts to this folder. So let's say a sockpot script. I don't know if this will work because this is not a Lua file. Can I just do that? .lua? No, that's just the name. All right, guys, we're making a script. Oh, that's not what I wanted to type. All right, there we go. Let's save that. And let's save that. Save as. We're going to want to do all files and we're going to want to save it as a Lua. Okay, no, not a TXT, dude. I want just a Lua file. But you guys get the point. You would be able to load up saved scripts from this section. And over here, you also have a small script hub that I think they're planning on adding more scripts to. So, you know, pretty classic. I think Synapse had the same script on their script hub. And you got also like a noclip script or like a fly script. And of course, infinite yield. So just like some basic stuff that you guys can try out and use, which are useful. But of course, you can also use your own scripts. One thing is that their script support isn't the best right now, but they are working with their devs to try to improve that and get better UNC rating and more script support. But that's still undergoing and on the way. But seeing that it is free and you guys can use it without having to, you know, pay anything, I think it's fair enough. The current support it has, you know, it functions well enough. But I think they are still improving it. So it will continue to get better if you guys are trying to use a script and it doesn't work so far. And if you're having any issues with the executor right now and you don't know what to do or how to fix it, they automatically invite you to their Discord when you open it, or you can also join the link in the description. I'll leave the Discord so you guys can try to get support from there. But thank you for sticking along till the end. Make sure to check out this video on how to get Eve on executor if you want to use executors on an emulator or on your phone and have more support as it is right now, or check out that other video right there where I went on Brookhaven with a server-sided backdoor exploit and stabbed people, okay, in Roblox, and then air bombed them. It was crazy. Check that video out. It was super entertaining, and I'll catch y'all in one of them. Go watch one. Bye bye.